Cranial nerve 11 is the spinal accessory nerve. Some people just call it the accessory nerve. You'll see both terms, spinal accessory or accessory, but the bottom line is it's simply a motor nerve. It innervates two muscles, the sternocleidomastoid muscle and the trapezius muscle. The sternocleidomastoid you can see in the anterior part of the neck when you turn your neck. You can see that muscle here. And your trapezius is what allows you to shrug your shoulders. The spinal accessory nerve has an unusual course. The cell bodies of origin are within the cervical spinal cord. So the axons leave the cord, come up through the foramen magnum, which is here, and that is where the foramen magnum is where the brainstem goes through. So your spinal cord on one side and brainstem on the other. So once they come up through the foramen magnum, then they turn laterally and then exit. So here's the foramen magnum. Here's the spinal accessory nerve coming in this way. And then it joins with 9 and 10 to exit through the jugular foramen and then exits out the base of the skull on the side through the jugular foramen and then comes around to innervate the sternocleidomastoid and the trapezius. So it's kind of weird. It doesn't have any cell bodies that live in the brainstem. That's all in the spinal cord. The reason, and this gets really tricky and isn't anything I'm going to test you on, but something you may run across in your future studies of neuroscience, the sternocleidomastoid and the trapezius have a funny origin. And because they arise from a different place embryonically than the rest of your muscles, this gets classified as a cranial nerve. So in summary, what do I want you to know about these things? So I want you to know what types of sensation are relayed by the glossopharyngeal nerve and from what regions or structures. Which gland is innervated by the glossopharyngeal nerve? Which cranial nerve innervates the muscles of the tongue? And what muscles are innervated by the spinal accessory nerve? If you have a grasp on all of these concepts, then you're ready for the assessment.